ओके, लेट्स हैव अ क्विक रिविजन ऑफ फिजिकल बैरियर इन नॉन स्पेसिफिक, दैट इज इननेट रेजिस्टेंस सिस्टम. इट विल बी जस्ट अ 5 मिनट रिविजन. इट विल बी क्विक. इफ यू हैव सीन प्रीवियस सेशंस, इट दिस सेशन इज फॉर यू फॉर द रिविजन पर्पज. सो वी नो दैट फिजिकल और इट इज़ अ मैकेनिकल बैरियर. इट इज़ 24/7 एक्टिव एंड इट इज़ द फर्स्ट लाइन ऑफ डिफेंस मैकेनिज्म टू द माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म. इट इज़ नॉन स्पेसिफिक, राइट? इट इंक्लूड मेजरली स्किन एंड म्यूकोसल मेम्ब्रेन ऑफ मैनी ऑर्गन्स. इफ यू टॉक अबाउट स्किन फर्स्ट, सो इट इज़ अ इंटेक्ट लेयर विच सेपरेट द बॉडी इंटरनल कंपोनेंट टू द एनवायरमेंट. एंड दिस स्किन इज मेड अप ऑफ कैरेटिनोसाइट सेल विच इज प्रोड्यूस कैरेटीन. इफ यू सी द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ स्किन हियर, सो इन दिस देर आर 3 वेज वाई दिस स्किन इज प्रोटेक्टिंग द बॉडी फ्रॉम द माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म. फर्स्ट इज दे आर हैविंग द स्वेट ग्लैंड्स एंड थ्रू स्वेट ग्लैंड्स दे विल रिलीज स्वेट ऑन द सर्फेस. सेकेंड इज दे आर हैविंग ऑयल ग्लैंड्स. Through oil glands, they will release oil on the surface. So sweat will provide high concentration of NaCl on the surface. Oil will not allow other microorganism to adhere on the surface. And next, last one, that is the normal flora of microorganism which is present on the skin. This flora will produce certain organic acids, and Staphylococcus is a normal flora of the skin. So it is not going to allow any microorganisms to survive on the surface. Mostly the pH of this medium is pH of the skin is around 5 to 6. So bacteria are not able to grow in this on this pH, but fungus can grow. So sometimes we are having a fungus infection. If through rupture of skin some microorganism trying to enter the body, at the bottom layer they are having salt, that is skin associated lung lymphoid tissue. This lymphoid tissue will eliminate the microorganism which trying to enter from the skin and trying to enter in the bloodstream. Okay, next is about mucous membrane. Mucous membrane is a sticky membrane which is present on eye, respiratory, digestive and urinogenital tract. This mucous membrane is able to produce many specific antimicrobial secretions. Basically those secretions are having different chemical, but the major chemical is the lysozyme enzyme. This lysozyme enzyme has ability to crack the alpha beta 1,4 linkage which is present in the surface, that is cell wall of microorganism. This cell wall will be broken by this enzyme, and if once the cell wall is broken, internal component will come out and that microorganism is not able to survive. Okay, another mechanism which is observed in this mucous membrane is production of superoxide radical. Usually we know that microorganism required oxygen for the survival, but if oxygen is present in excess form and in the radical form, they cannot survive. So in certain mucous membrane, one enzyme is secreted which is lactoperoxidase. This will catalyze the oxygen to produce superoxide, and in presence of this rich oxygen reactive environment, microorganism is not able to survive. There are certain other mucus associated lymphoid tissue, that is MALT, gut associated lymphoid tissue, that is GALT, bronchial associated lymphoid tissue, that is BALT, is present in different mucous membrane of different organs, and that they will protect it. If microorganism is there, they can produce certain chemicals to eliminate them. Okay, this we have seen. Now let's focus to system to system. This is our respiratory tract. This is how the air is inhaled. It is observed that usually we inhale 10,000 microorganism per day, but the concept is the microorganism which is larger than 10 micrometer. This 10 micrometer से बड़े microorganism जो है वो nasal cavity में block हो जाते हैं, but कुछ microorganism जो है जो less than 10 mm है, they will trying to enter in the track, that can be eliminate through coughing or sneezing. जो यहाँ पे एनकाउंटर हो जाते हैं, दे विल गो टू द फेरिंग्स एंड थ्रू फेरिंग्स इट कैन बी स्प्लिटेड आउट, राइट? तो दिस इज अ काइंड ऑफ स्नीजिंग, कफिंग इज अ काइंड ऑफ डिफेंस मैकेनिज्म ऑफ बॉडी टू एलिमिनेट द माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म. इफ सम माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म एंटर इन द लोअर पोर्शन ऑफ द रेस्पिरेटरी ट्रैक, there will be a specialized cell which is called as a alveolar macrophage. Alveoli is present here. This macrophage will remove these microorganisms by the process of phagocytosis. Next, how defense mechanism will help in gastrointestinal tract. So once you consume the food, it will go in the stomach. The stomach is highly acidic, it has a pH of 2 to 3 region. So in this environment, obviously microorganism could not survive, but few species of microorganism like Helicobacterium, Staphylococcus, toxins, they can survive. If food is embedded, if microorganism is embedded in food particle, they also get invade that stomach highly acidic condition and they can enter in the intestine. But there is a one more mechanism which is present in the intestine. The intestinal mucosal membrane cell is called as peanut cell. They produce certain antibiotic compound which is called as a cryptins. These cryptins are antimicrobial and highly toxic to the certain bacteria which enter in the intestine. Just focus on this bold part, okay? Last, how genitourinary tract is being sterile, what is the defensive mechanism of those tract for the microorganism is the second last point of the topic. In that, it is found that urine is sterile. Urine flush to the kidney and to the urinary tract so that any microorganism which is trying to enter, they can remove. Okay. Second, they contain urea, uric acid, hippuric acid, which is highly toxic to the microorganism. So microorganism get killed. Okay. There is one more mechanism that is estrogen influence mechanism in the vaginal tract, in the vaginal region. In those cells, if estrogen is released, they will elevate the amount of glycogen which is present in that area. So that glycogen is very toxic to lactobacillus species, which is usually found in that epithelial cells of vagina. So this is how this vagina is being protected. Last one is the eye. How this eye is being protected. So eye is having the lacrimal glands on the top as well as on the besides. And if some unwanted thing is entered in the eye, this lacrimal gland will start secreting the lacrimal fluid. This lacrimal fluid mostly contain enzyme lysozyme, which mechanism we have discussed before. They will break down the cell wall of the microorganism, lactoferrin and antigen A. These are the things which can protect the microorganisms which degrade the microorganism which entered in the eye, and they can protect them. This is about the revision of physical barrier, which is very useful to human in case of survival. Okay.